Okay, I'm Erdem. I'm from Istanbul and currently working in Netmera. Netmera is basically a mobile backend as a service platform. And actually today I want to talk about advanced rich push notifications in Android platform. Our talk contains some elements. We will start with why do we use push notifications in Android platform? Actually, why do we use push notifications in any way? Then we talk about general structure of sending and receiving push notifications. And then we will go one step further and talk about rich push notifications, an advanced way of sending push notifications. And then we focus on sending notifications into a specific group of people. We will do this via sending group-based push notifications and also location-based notifications. And lastly, we'll talk about geofencing concept. Geofencing concept is nothing but an automated way of sending location-based push notifications. We will see each of them in detail. Okay. Let's start. Why do we use push notifications? May I see the hands who use push notifications already in their applications? Okay, there are some people. And if you look, why do we use them? The main reason is a communication between the application user. Because when we put our applications into Google Play Store, our communication between the application and application users becomes limited. But we may send push notifications to applications at any time. Any time is an important concept because even the application is closed, we can send messages and they just appear to the screen. So this is an important thing. We just send any message at any time, and maybe the application isn't opened since 2 weeks or maybe for much, much longer time. But we can send a simple message and user return our application. They remember our application. And there is a research which is done 30,000 people, and there are some reasons why we use push notifications. First reason is to notify the audience about new updates or maybe new apps of the developer. The second goal is to send special offers to the users, and we will see these to send special offers in detail while talking about rich push notifications. And the third goal is about inform new content. We may update our application. We may just add some new levels to application and remember our application to our users. And there are also some other reasons like sending ads, links, all kind of etc. And if you look the general structure of push notifications, there are four main elements. Our mobile devices, basically mainly the most important one, and Google Cloud Messaging in Android platform. Google Cloud Messaging sends messages to our devices. We also have a server and a database to store related information at background. And let's look at their relationship. Our scenario starts with sending a request to Google Cloud Messaging. And this request contains a sender ID, and this is obtained also from Google. And Google Cloud Messaging returns us a unique registration ID. This registration ID is unique for application, not for mobile device. Each application has a unique registration IDs, and we have to store them in a place. And this place is actually our server. So we send another request to our server to store these registration IDs. And server stores them in database. This is the registration part. And when we want to send notifications to our users, we just take these registration IDs from our database. This is a simple query. And we just send these registration IDs to Google Cloud Messaging server, and Google Cloud Messaging server sends our messages to mobile devices. This is the main concept. And if you see the red arrows, the red ones are related with the registration part, and the blue ones is actually about sending notifications. If you do the two blue arrows again and again, we just send the different messages again and again. Let's talk about rich push concept. Mainly when you send a normal push notifications, it's just nothing but a simple plain text and a static content. But we may want to change this concept. We may go further and send maybe images, videos, or maps, and they actually more creative. And if we send well-designed push notifications, the user engagement will also increase. Let's talk about an example. Maybe we have a retailer all around the Germany, and this retailer company also have a online shopping application. So they just want to send promotions about their products and want to send this kind of inserts or maybe their brand's location information within a map. Also, they want to, if you look the, how can we add something, images, videos, or maps? This is nothing but HTML content. And we can also change these HTML contents by calling some JavaScript functions maybe. And maybe you can see that there is my name in top of the, at the right one. It says, "Hello, Erdem Yilmaz." We can add some user-related information and change this information inside HTML content. Let's see how this can be done. Our registration steps are similar to the previous, the basic one. We just get registration IDs from Google Cloud Messaging and store them in our servers, in databases. But when we want to send a rich push notification, we just simply send a content ID and also actually our message. And Google Cloud Messaging send these messages and content IDs to mobile devices. And the mobile devices receive the message and push content ID. They just send, send the push content ID to our server again. And server returns us the HTML content itself. This is HTML content, so we can show it in a web view, basically. And user can see the HTML content. As I said before, we call some JavaScript functions, maybe. And also, maybe we can call some native Java functions inside JavaScript, inside the HTML part. There are two different methods. Actually, when we talk about sending rich push notifications, why we don't send the HTML content itself? There are two reasons, actually. Because the content may be a large file. And Google Cloud Messaging lets us to send up to 4 kilobyte messages. The messages, lower than 4 kilobyte, but we just send images, videos, and their sizes maybe much longer than 4 kilobyte. And also there is another reason, because when we send our rich push content HTML, the user easily delete the notification and don't want to see the notification. So we just send a huge file and user doesn't know what's going on at the background, and we just simply consumes user's data plan, and we generally don't want something like that. So when the user actually wants to see the content itself, we just send another request to our server and get the HTML content. So the user also knows what's going on. Okay, up to that point, we sent normal push notifications or maybe rich push notifications, but all of the users will receive these notifications. We just broadcasted notifications to all of the users. But we may want to send notifications to a specific group of people. So we want to separate our users according to maybe their interests, their usage type of our application, or maybe their characteristic. Let's give an example for each one. Remember, we have an online shopping application, and when the user open the application, we may just take their interested product types. They just want to receive information about, let's say, sports equipment, and when we have a promotion about makeup equipment, the ones that are interested with the sports equipment actually doesn't want to receive these makeup promotions. So we may take their interests and send according to their interests. We may also send according to their usage type. It's nothing but taking information at the background. Suppose user bought a microphone, a camera, and a monitor. So we just label this type users as a tech lovers. And when we want to make a promotion about electronical device, we just send these promotions to tech lovers type users. Maybe we can get the idea from characteristic of users. Just suppose our application has a Facebook login, and we just take users' relationship information. When we want to send a promotion about Valentine's Day, we don't want to actually send a promotion to our single users. We just want to send them to users who has a relation. And these examples can be increased easily. And we want to send group-based notifications. The registration part has a small differences. We just take the registration IDs again, and when we want to send registration IDs to our servers, we simply add a group list. And this group list, as I said before, can obtain in different ways. We just update our registration ID records with the given user group list. And when we want to send notification to a specific group, we just take related registration IDs. This is actually another simple query. When we get the registration IDs from our database, send them to the Google Cloud Messaging, and Google Cloud Messaging also sends them to our mobile devices. That's it. Okay, we send according to their interested areas, but because our devices are mobile, the users probably change their locations frequently. And we also want to send messages according to their locations. We just want to send in a specific area, and if a person inside this specific area, only the ones who are inside the specific area will receive the notifications. Let's go back our example. We have a different kind of branches in all over the Germany. Suppose we have a Munich branch and also Berlin branch, and we want to a promotion related with the Berlin branch. If the user who lives in Germany gets a notification about Berlin branch, he probably doesn't want to get a notification about Berlin branch because it's too far away, and it's nothing but a spam kind of messages. So how this can be done? Let's look at it. We just get a registration ID again, and it's similar to the group-based notifications. This time we just send users current location, and this current location can be obtained easily with a location listener in Android. And we may update this location information again and again because, as I said before, this is a mobile device and users probably change their locations over time. So we update the location registration ID record with the given location information. And when we want to send a message, we just take the specific area and get the location informations if the informations inside the specified area. We'll collect these registration IDs, and like we sent before, we just send the registration IDs to Google Cloud Messaging, and Google Cloud Messaging also sends the messages to our mobile devices. Also, these examples will be maybe a rich push notifications. This, when we just send the messages, we also can send content IDs, and via another request, we just get rich push HTML content and show to the user. Okay, we just have another concept: geofencing. Geofencing is an advanced way of sending location-based push notifications. We may want to send into a specific area again and again. Actually, let's talk about geofence concept. Geofence means predefined set of boundaries, and if we may want to send a notification if the user enters this specified zone. This is also contains an automated function, because we should check again and again if the user entered the specified zone or not. And we may have an example like that. Suppose we opened another branch in a city, and we just want to inform about this new branch who lives near to this branch. So we may easily set a geofence zone over the new opened branch and set a period of time. If the user enters this zone in this specified time, he just received a notification, actually. Let's talk about the structural side. Our scenario this time starts with listening location information. And we do it again and again, as I said before. And in every update, we just send the latest location information to our users. And inside at the server side part, we just check whether the location is inside the geofence zone or not. If it is not, we simply go back and listen the location information again. If it is inside the geofence zone, we just check whether this is the first registration or not. Because why do we do that? Because this is the registration. Registration must be done for one time, because suppose we have a large geofence area and the user changed location inside the geofence area. If another update request is inside the geofence zone, we simply send the same message again and again. So we want to do it. We want to do it once, and it may be the first registration time. And if it is not, we again go back and start to listening location. If it is the first time, we simply send our registration IDs to Google Cloud Messaging. And Google Cloud Messaging sends also our messages to our devices. And we will check inside the mobile devices whether this is a rich push notification or not by looking the message contains a content ID or not. If it is not contain an ID, we just finish our job and show the notification. But if there is a content ID, we just go again and take our rich push HTML content and show to the user, actually. This is the summarization of geofencing concepts. And let's talk about push ethics. This is an important point, I think so, because I'm also an application developer and also an application user. And if you look at these these details, there are actually some annoying things. Probably if you are a developer, you don't never ever send spam. The messages should contain application related information. And actually sending messages too frequent again and again may annoy the user, and user simply deletes our application. But suppose we have a peer-to-peer communication application. In a situation like that, we may send messages frequently, but it may change according to our application behavior. So it actually depends on the application behavior. We should also make a good targeting and select the related users to send push notifications. It's also an important concept, and we talk about that. And also, you should create some meaningful, valuable messages to interact with users to increase user engagement. It's also an important point. And lastly, I want to talk about backend server side part. All of that stuff is related with the backend side. And creating backend side may take a quite big time, also an effort, as you can see in previous examples. Actually, if the application owner and developer is different, and when the application owner doesn't know anything about development, you may have a user interface about managing push notifications, maybe. So you should also create some web UI, actually. And as Netmera, we provide a multiple platform SDK. In also Android, we have a SDK. And lets developers to use our features like cloud data, media content, user management, and also push notifications. We will also provide some web UI features to send and manage push notifications, and even the non-developer people can easily use these elements and send push notifications to users. And as Netmera will help you to, we want to help developers actually. And actually, this is end of my talk. You can see detailed information about these links. You can also contact me via erdem.yilmaz@netmera.com. And if there are questions.